changes. In 1776, this great nation accepted that armed conflict was the only way to preserve our rights to life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. If our founding fathers could only see us now. From Antietam to Amiens, Okinawa to Anchorage,
we have fought. And now, the Red Menace is at our doorstep. Democracy itself is under threat of annihilation. That is why today, July 4th, 2076, 300 years after our great nation began, we gather together to honor the completion of Vault 76. This sprawling underground shelter may have been engineered by Vault Tech, but it was built by you, the good people of America, so that if the bombs do come, if the end does come, our way of life will endure. But not everyone will be saved. Those chosen to enter this vault must be our best and our brightest. For when the fighting is stopped and the fallout has settled, you must rebuild. Not just walls, not just buildings, but hearts and minds, and ultimately, America itself. So as we stand here today, we pray that the world will know peace. But if that is not our destiny, if war must come, we stand together knowing that here in Vault 76, our future begins.
Vault 76. You come from every walk of life, every race, color, and creed. But you all share one very important trait. You are this country's best and brightest. But more importantly, you'll always be my family. nothing less than the rebuilding of America. Such a huge responsibility. Just know that Vault-Tec is proud of you. I am proud of you. When you hear this, it means I've been gone for several hours. I've got my own mission out there in Appalachia. This is the Overseer.
Hunger and thirst can increase your disease risk. You do not want to contract weeping sores. Believe you me. Constant alert for the clickety-click of your Pip-Boy's built-in radiation meter. Oh, come on. Building a personal power grid and making your own electricity? How hard could it be? You must all go through that giant vault door alone. Unless, of course, you're next to someone else. Which I'd recommend, actually. Need a cooking station? Use your cam.
A new house?
Your cam. Some small luxuries? Your cam! A battleship! Sir, possess the skills necessary to accomplish anything. I'm sure of it. Teamwork. It's what built America.
Overseer's log, or should I say, direct communication. Because whoever is listening to this had the moxie to try to find out where I've gone. But I'm glad you did. Truth is, I need your help. I've been given a task and I've decided to break protocol and tell you what it is. Because if there's one thing I've learned in these past few years, it's that we need to rely on each other. There were three active nuclear silos in Appalachia before the bombs fell. They blew up the world before. We can't let it happen again. So we've got to locate and secure all of the silos. Or die trying. Hopefully the former. But it's been 25 years. I just don't know what we're gonna find out there. Or where to start. My directive was to go to the nearest population center and assess the situation. I'll set up a camp on the way once I get my bearings. Find me there.
grow up so fast.
Happy Reclamation Day. Now go get 'em. Have fun. Try not to die. The entire country is counting on you. So please, for the love of God, don't screw this up.
No!
South of Vault 76. I knew this wasn't going to be the Appalachia I remembered, but mutated animals, haywire bots, and no people so far. We have to be ready to rebuild in what I can confirm is hostile territory. Fortunately, Vault Tech was prepared. See this? The cooking station, the stash box, the workbenches, all built with the camp. You need a home base out there. The construction and assembly mobile platform is designed to give you one. Just add resources, planning, and a little elbow grease. When you move your camp, everything you've built is stored, ready to be placed back down in the new area. Use this to establish a foothold whenever you're in unfamiliar territory. I've left my camp behind so you can use it. I know I'm breaking my own advice by not taking it with me. But after seeing Appalachia for myself, I need to make sure every resident of 76 has a safe haven they can start from. I'll make do without it. If it's still standing, the town of Flatwoods is further down this road. Find me there. This is the Overseer, signing off.
Okay.
Sets of 12 reps. Let's see. Dumbbell bicep curls, tricep extensions. And back extensions, yeah. A little peeve about the lack of proper equipment. No bother. Chin up. Only 8 more luxury coffins to make quota in backwoods. I mean, flatwoods. So, be difficult given the financial situation around here. Just need to remind them of our friends the Chinese. Yeah, I'll be back on the plane to Ipswich within a fortnight. Gather it'll be the bench press today. Yeah, again.
Hunter's log, town of Flatwoods. My God. There's no one here. The old tavern, the church, people were using them for shelter, but they're gone. Mutations we expected. But there's something else. A disease. I was attacked by... Well, it used to be a person. But it had these green, glowing lesions, and its voice. Angry. Tortured. We are one. One what? Whatever happened here is beyond anything we expected. And we expected a lot. Before they were wiped out, the survivors called themselves the Responders. Looks like they were made of firefighters, police, emergency medical staff. They even have an automated system to teach people about treating water. Survival. I'm doing their tests, and you should too. I know it's even worse than we imagined, but... Someone's got to know where the missile silos are, and how to secure them. The Responders are the best lead we have. This is the Overseer, signing off.
Our stories for posterity, you know. Well, seems like a fine idea. So, hi, I am Kesha McDermott. When the bombs fell, I was in Watoga, coordinating a statewide science fair for that year's high school kids. And the theme was the future of energy. After the bombs, everything was pretty chaotic. Scavenging for food and fighting off rabid survivors. Oh, it was just a bad time all around. I found a couple of surviving kids from the high school whose parents didn't make it. And we holed up in a house in town for a while. After a bit, I was able to solder the circuitry in an old radio, and we tuned in to a broadcast from the Responders. Oh, we were overjoyed. The trip from Watoga to Flatwoods, it was rough, mind you. The kids and I ran into a group of assholes in the mountains who stole our food and water. I can't tell you how happy I was to find the Responders in Flatwoods. Tents for everyone, open kitchens, medical supplies, protection. We were safe. They had a problem, though. Their water sources were contaminated heavily. People were boiling water, but not long enough to make it safe. So, I said, I'll build a testing kit to monitor the contamination. contamination, and I will teach folks how to properly boil water. And I did. The world is getting better, but slowly. We need to make sure it doesn't relapse, too. It's going to take time and care, that's all. Well, time, care, and science.
Just fine out there. Hey, volunteer. If you need supplies, Baba's got you covered.
First interview with another survivor, Kesha McDermott. She found me trying to break into a Nuka-Cola machine and showed me a different way. So, Kesha, can you tell us a bit about how we can make sure our water is safe for drinking? I'll try to keep it to the basics for training purposes.
Oh, it's not complicated, really. Find water and strain out any big particles and chunks. Then, boil it in a pot over an open fire for a minute or two, then let it cool. Should be fine. Like making tea, right?
Uh-huh. You joined the responders a while ago and helped develop a program to train volunteers. So, were you a survivalist prior to all of this?
You could say that. I taught high school kids. I used to talk about this very thing to them. Practical application of the sciences. It's fascinating, but you never realize how important some things will be down the road, do you?
I guess not. So if we were students of yours, what would you tell us about the world now? How can we survive?
That's a good question, Dasa. Well, I would tell you all to remain calm and focus on surviving. The first thing you need to do is get yourself some clean drinking water. It's likely all you'll find.
Automated warning to all responders. Mr. Farmhands are out of control. Evacuate civilians and take down those supervisors. Once they're dealt with, you'll have to reboot the server. Again.
Mm-hmm. Delbert Winters here, born and raised in this very town. Lent my own church to the responders for their outpost here, and you're welcome. The responders are on a true mission, you see, helping folks through thick and thin, till the heavens open up again and take us all up anyways. When this all happened, I figured like most, it was time. This was the end, but it wasn't, was it? We're still here. At first, I thought it was a mistake, that we was missed, forgotten. Maybe we did some wrong. Didn't give enough to charity, maybe. Didn't praise his name, even in the worst of times. Maybe thought some things that ought not to have been thought. So I asked him. I asked how? Why? I fought your wars on Earth. I'm ready to fight them up there by your side. Then, in my despair, I saw some survivors eating raw rat carcass behind the dumpster. You ought to cook that first, I warned them. Seemed obvious. We tried but got sick, they said, covered in their own filth. I realized right then and there that I was being tasked. From then on, I built kitchens, cooked good food, fed anyone who walked up with an empty belly. And I was thankful for my task in life. Thankful. Next time hell or high water land in my stoop, I'll be swept clear away with it. But till then, let's share a home-cooked meal together, all right?
If you're here to sign up, just use one of our handy dandy terminals.
Hi. Dasa asked me if I would talk about, how I got here. She asked everybody, so I said okay. My name's Colonel, and I'm 13 years old. I just wanted to say I'm sorry. I'm sorry for everything. The bombs and the messed up people, the cows with two heads, all of it. I was bad. Bad. I cheated on my spelling test. I kicked Chip Wilkins in the shins until he cried. I pushed Rosie McCloy down the stairs. I cut holes in the bottom of all the gym shorts and put glue in the mashed potatoes in the cafeteria. I told Harold Newell to eat 10 dead flies a day in order to grow muscles, and I put new Coca-Cola in the rat cage water bottles at the pet store. And, I just wanted to say I'm sorry about everything. My dad said if I wasn't this way, the bad things wouldn't happen. I haven't seen Daddy since the bombs, and I guess he left because of that, too. It's okay. I'm trying to be good now, though. I'm not old enough to be a volunteer, but Dasa said I could help collect food and water, so I'm getting better, I promise. And, Daddy, if you're listening, I promise I won't be bad anymore, so you can come back now. Okay. Okay.
Thank you.
Okay, gang, the boss wanted me to leave you some instructions, since you apparently can't run this mine without me holding your hand. We're gonna light this place up today. The holes are drilled, so just get the dynamite packed in and wired up. Make sure everyone's a safe distance this time. Tommy, you do not touch the plungers. Got it? You're the reason we're down two guys this month. Carl, you're in charge. Don't fuck this up.
folks. This is Jeff Nakamura from the responders. We've set up a camp at Flatwoods, and we're offering supplies, medical treatment, and survival training to anyone in need. Look for us in the church across from the Flatwoods Tavern, and if you can volunteer some time to help out, we could definitely use it. This message will repeat. Folks, this is Jeff Nakamura from the responders. We've set up a camp at Flatwoods, and we're offering supplies, medical treatment, and survival training to anyone in need. Look for us in the church across from the Flatwoods Tavern, and if you can volunteer some time to help out, we could definitely use it. This message will repeat. Folks, this is Jeff Nakamura of the responders. We've set up a camp at Flatwoods, and we're offering supplies, medical treatment, and survival training to anyone in need. Look for us in the church across from the Flatwoods Tavern, and if you can volunteer some time to help out, we could definitely use it. This message will repeat. This is Jeff Nakamura of the responders. We've set up a camp at Flatwoods, and we're offering supplies, medical treatment, and survival training to anyone in need. Look for us in the church across from the Flatwoods Tavern, and if you can volunteer some time to help out, we could definitely use it. This message will repeat. This is Jeff Nakamura of the responders. We've set up a camp at Flatwoods, and we're offering supplies, medical treatment, and survival training to anyone in need. Look for us in the church across from the Flatwoods Tavern, and if you can volunteer some time to help out, Tavern, and if you can volunteer some time to help out, we could definitely use this message for you. Hi, folks. This is Jeff Nakamura of the responders. We set up a camp at Flatwoods. We're offering supplies, medical treatment, and survival training. Look for us in a church across from the Flatwoods Tavern, and volunteer some time to help out. This message will repeat. Hi, folks. This is Jeff Nakamura of the responders. We've set up a camp at Flatwoods, and we're offering supplies, medical treatment, and survival training to anyone in need. Look for us in the church across from the Flatwoods Tavern, and if you can... this message will repeat. Hi, folks. This is Jeff Nakamura from the responders. We've set up a camp at Flatwoods, and we're offering supplies. Look for us in the church across from the Flatwoods Tavern, and if you can volunteer some time to help out, we could definitely use it. This message will repeat. Hi, folks. This is Jeff Nakamura of the Responders. We've set up a camp at Flatwoods. We're offering supplies, medical training, and survival training to anyone in need. Look for us in the church across from the Flatwoods Tavern, and if you can volunteer some time to help out, we could definitely use it. This message will repeat. Folks, this is Jeff Nakamura of the Responders. We've set up a camp at Flatwoods, and we're offering supplies, medical treatment, and survival training to anyone in need. Look for us in the church across from the Flatwoods Tavern, and if you can volunteer some time to help out, we could definitely use it. Hi, folks. This is Jeff Nakamura, the Responders. We've set up a camp at Flatwoods. We're offering supplies, medical treatment.
You are listening to WGRF, Garethum Radio. I am your host, the mayor of Garethum. Okay, is anybody listening? Anybody? That's what I thought. Well, if anyone does hear this, please come see me at City Hall. I have something that... But never mind, just come see me right away. As in now, or sooner... You are listening to WGRF, Garethum Radio. I am your host, the mayor of Garethum. Okay, is anybody listening? Anybody? That's what I thought. Well, if anyone does... Please come see me at City Hall. You are listening to WGRF, Garethum Radio. I am your host, the mayor of Garethum. Okay, is anybody listening? Anybody? That's what I thought. Well, if anyone does hear this, please come see me at City Hall. I have something that... never mind, just come see me. Listening to WGRF, Garethum Radio. I am your host, the mayor of Garethum. Okay, is anybody listening? Anybody? That's what I thought. Well, if anyone does hear this, please come see me at City Hall. I have something that... never mind, just come see me right away. As in now or sooner... You are listening to WGRF, Garethum Radio. I am your host, the mayor of Garethum. Okay, is anybody listening? Anybody? That's what I thought. Well, if anyone does hear this, please come see me at City Hall. I have something that... never mind, just come see me right away. As in now or sooner... You are listening to WGRF, Garethum Radio. I am your host, the mayor of Garethum. Okay, is anybody listening? Anybody? That's what I thought. Well, if anyone does... hear this, please come see me at City Hall. I have something that... never mind, just come see me right away. As in now or sooner... Listening to WGRF Grafton Radio. I am your host, the mayor of Grafton. Okay, is anybody listening? Anybody? That's what I thought. Well, if anyone does hear this, please come see me at City Hall. I have something that... never mind, just come see me right away. As in now or sooner... You are listening to WGRF Grafton Radio. I am your host, the mayor of Grafton. Okay, is anybody listening?
Thank you.
Divine Intruder detected. Beginning search. Hold it right there. Attempt to play. You will be identified and sanctioned. Ammunition and other supplies available for all responders.
Thank you.
hell of a week, I tell ya. We lost more good people fighting off those damn scorched things again. Now I got Chavez telling me we're picking up a new radio signal. Someone's asking for help. She wants me to take my team and follow it till we find them. Can't be too far. Already tracked to gaining strength south of here. Problem is, we'd have to go straight on through Raider country to find them. And I don't have the time or men to spare right now. So, I hate to say it, but I gotta tell her it ain't gonna happen. Not now. My team's the last line of defense. And if I take them on some wild goose chase, we're leaving ourselves open for another Christmas flood situation. And you can bet your ass I ain't gonna let that happen again. Even if it means someone out there might need us. Oh, man, alive, times have changed.
My name is Maria Chavez. And I am about to die. Scorched and overrun our defenses. They're... for us all. If you find this, the overseers of Ark, more in town. I used to love coming here on weekends, taking flight lessons. Now it feels like I walked into a nightmare. Those scorched things are everywhere. I kept quiet. They didn't see me. I managed to observe them for a bit. Whatever this disease is, it seems to completely take over its host. The ones that used to be human, eventually they go rigid, like some kind of stasis. And if they stay like that for too long, they sort of burn up from the inside out. Vesuvius in reverse. I wondered what could possibly cause all this. And then I got my answer. It swooped down from the sky, screeching, breathing, infecting everything. I don't know how to fight this. But we need to consider all our options. Even the nukes. We find the source of this scorched plague and wipe it from the map before it can leave Appalachia. But first things first, we can't let the disease spread to us. Looks like the responders were developing some kind of inoculation. I'm going to pick up their work. You should too. This is the Overseer, signing off.
Hey everyone. This is Derek. Making my final report on the events at Harper's Ferry. Hopefully this reaches you all safely. Whatever happened here, it was big. The whole area is... it's devastated. If any of our people survived, I can't find a trace of them. I talked to some of the locals. They say creatures came from the sky and laid waste to the town. Some of the ones who got hurt in the attack were transformed or something. They apparently turned into monsters and attacked anyone they could reach. Riley says he and his people are gonna seal themselves up in their bunkers and try to figure out a way to fight these creatures. In other words, we won't be getting any more help from these Free States guys. Maria, I was hoping you could get in touch with Ella. See if maybe she can lean on Riley a little. Lead him to see that this isn't the way. If you ask me, I think it's damn selfish of them to turn their backs on the rest of us. We're people who need their help to survive. There's nothing else I can do here. Guess we can scratch Harper's Ferry off the map. I'll be heading back soon. But I want to check in on some of the farms along the way. Should be about a week.
Thank you.
primary directive. All trees must become desirable wood products. Please enjoy this complimentary sample of wood. Additional wood samples are unavailable at this time. Desirable wood product unavailable. Please return at a later time.